holding it together, making it a safe place, and giving self-worth, significance. You know, if you've got, I've got grandsons, and what they love doing is copying Dad. And so, you know, when they're about four, if Dad was doing a job in the garden, they wanted to be there with their little trowel and their little rake and be doing what Dad was doing. And that's affirming. Dad needs to be the role model for a boy. But a dad is also extremely important in that transition for a girl going through the teens. Affirming the girl as she goes through that difficult time to become a young lady, okay? And a lot of broken relationships and the lack of the complete parenting that we were designed to have. So we designed to have hearts full because of all that love flowing from God in the waterfall, okay? Out in the fallen world, it hasn't been like that. Here we are here, and maybe we've got our parents. Maybe one has a broken heart. Maybe one had a difficult time. And what they've got bits of love, and they give the love they can. I'm not knocking parents, I'm a parent. And we're not knocking parents. It's just the fact of life is that we were born to be filled, and we haven't in the fallen world, because the damage goes back. Because their parents here, they may have been through the war, they may have been all sorts of circumstances, and so they only got a bit from here, and there's another broken heart there, in that, and they only got back a bit. So what you get is in the fallen world, nobody gets perfect everything. Alright? Nobody. There is nobody here in this room or in any other room that hasn't got some deficit, some hole here, some wound here, so that instead of being the image that we should be, we're squashed and we're distorted, because in the fallen world we haven't been sustained in the way that God intended us to be. And so all of us have got a journey of restoration, but we need to take that in the Spirit. Pace. Most of us, if we look at the wounds in our life and trace them back, what will be at the root is broken relationships. Because of that instant reaction, that instant lack of trust, that instant coming in, those negative things, the fear and the shame, the anger, the blame. Okay? Those things are not good in relationships. If you're not trusting in relationships, these are the things that break down. And so, out here, with this hole, with my bucket to be filled here, but because I was created to have this foundation, knowing I was loved and I belonged, knowing that I got value and worth, knowing I was significant, there was a meaning and purpose. Knowing there's an emptiness, knowing there's a yearning for more, but I don't know what it is. I will go where I can to fill my bucket, so I feel some of it, so I feel a little bit loved. So I feel that I have some worth. So that I feel that maybe I'm significant. And so I have my own programming. Okay? I will go and do this in the bucket. I will go and do that in the bucket. I will go and do this in the bucket. And if I'm in trouble, well, I'll drag you all down, help He's good. He blesses, he teaches us, he heals us, even when we're outside. But okay, thanks, you did that, Lord, but I need to go on there. I need to go on it. If you want to prove this, we've just sung. Well, we've been here, these songs. And tomorrow morning, people will come into churches and they'll sing things like, Jesus is Lord. All right? You're Lord God, Lord of my life. How great is God? But then they'll go home, and as they sit over dinner and they think about the week ahead, they get worried, oh, I've got to do this, I've got to do that, and oh dear, I don't know what we're going to do about this. Freezer's broken down, they said, oh dear, I don't know what we're going to do this. I know what I'll do, I'll make a plan. And we plan what we think is the best, because that was the fruit. This is the killer. This is the killer, the fruit. We think we know best. So we're doing our best. We're trying to survive. We're trying to make life work. So in those 25 years, I shut God out of my life. And I was a nightmare to my friends and my family. I made a hash of two marriages. I damaged my children. I did all sorts of things. But I was doing my best. I was trying to make it work. I was working so hard, so that moment, that Thursday in August, I was exhausted. That's why there was no more of me left, because I had expended it all, going in the wrong place to try and get what God had got on offer for me here. Now, when I was saved, it was a Thursday. I knew I needed a church, and I knew I needed some help to sort out my head. And I knew I needed the vicar, who was a psychologist. But they're not very hard. They are pretty hard to find. But I found one 20 minutes away. So by the next week, I was going to see him. And actually, I went to see him for 10 and a half years, but twice a week. Which is why I would be able to share what I'm going to share later on, because that was my kind of university. And I knew my story. Well, I didn't know what to do with it. And then I started going to Waverley and to CWR. This was founded by a chap called Selwyn Hughes. You might have heard of him. Yeah. It's Every Day with Jesus. And he became a counsellor, because one time somebody came to him for help, and he talked to him, and then this guy went away and committed suicide. And he wanted to know, to learn how to help. And so he went to America and he met Larry Crabb. And what he did was, together, they brought this diagram into being. So when I went to Waverley, and sat there, and this was explained, just as I've explained it to you, okay? And when I saw it, I thought, wow, now I understand. I'm living my life in the wrong place. Now, all this stuff that I knew about but was still a burden to me, I've got something to do with it. It's sin, hooray, it's sin, because my people have committed two sins. They've turned away from me, the spring of living water, and they dug their own cisterns that cannot hold water. Right, I can say, sorry, God. I am so sorry that I've lived my life out of this place. I can come back through the cross of Jesus, and I can come back clean into the presence of the Father. Wow. All that stuff, clean, free. And now, in this place, I can begin to learn who I am. I can let the Holy Spirit start transforming me from the inside out, equipping me. By stepping into the waterfall, I'm saying, Lord, from this point, I'm going to trust you for every part of my life. I'm joining you in your story. This is the step of a disciple, of total commitment, I'm with you. Okay? From now on, I don't want to live the world's way. I don't want to live my way, trying to fill my bucket. I don't want that. What I want to do is to follow Jesus. I want to be in your story, in the sustenance that you've given me, in the significance that you've given me, because I've got a job to do for you. There's a wonderful verse in Psalm 138, verse 9. The Lord will fulfill his purpose for me. If you choose to stand in this place, he'll get you to do everything that he has designed and you to do in the kingdom, in that jigsaw puzzle.